alternative, to say the least. That should smoke them out. They'll never survive without help.
That's enough. He's not here.
What's happened?
Beggars. They're rioting all throughout the district. You men, with me.
Reports that an assassin is nearby and that you are his intended target.
The worm has grown a spine. Now he's a snake.
Damn. It was only a matter of time I knew that much. This is far too soon.
Oh, we, my lord. The assassins are, well connected.
But we have the advantage now, don't we? Muster the guard and lead the hunt for this assassin. Bring me his head.
Dealing with uprisings among the beggars.
You men, with
Embarrassing.
Tricky, tricky, assassin. To the two of us, assassin.
My subjects have eyes everywhere, my lord. I offer their knowledge to the service of the Order.
What knowledge could a king of the gutters offer us? The intrigues of rats? You may go.
The intrigues of rats? Pompous fool, if I could lay my hands on him.
My master would be pleased to arrange that. Brother.
You're right, monsieur. Too much of the king's champagne.
Sire, come away!
It's done. De LaSerre is dead, Grandmaster.
Good. Ah, you're just in time for the commencement of my reign.
Your reign?
As long as there's a Cour des Miracles, we must have a Roi des Thunes. And since there seemed to be a vacancy, I stepped in.
With remarkable speed, the body's not yet cold.
I may have set things in motion a trifle early. Say, when we first arrived at La Cour des Miracles.
You used me.
Your target is dead. We used one another.
Quite a kingdom you've inherited.
It is, isn't it? So, is justice served? Are the dead avenged? Is your soul soothed, all that rot?
Rot is a fine description. Every time I think I'm getting close to the truth, it seems another layer of filth presents itself.
Conspiracy, intrigue, a rapidly thickening plot. Add some bestiality and a lecherous priest, and I say you have the beginnings of a beautiful novel.
I'd settle for a solid lead.
So young, and yet so serious. Well, best of luck to you. You have, I trust, looked into this.
Where did you get that?
One of my newly loyal subjects brought it to me as a token of esteem, as it were. It's a curious piece. I know of only one silversmith who works metal like this.
A blade of this make killed Monsieur de LaSerre. I can only assume you knew this already. Why didn't you say?
Well, where would man be if he never had to ask questions? If everything he could ever want to know was simply handed to him, he might no longer think to ask questions.
Or he might accomplish a great deal more unburdened by ignorance.
Perhaps. The smith's name is François Thomas Germain. You'll find his shop near Léal.
Thank you.
Bonne chance.
Something I can help you with?
What is this place?
It connects to the sanctuary. Less flashy than the Saint-Chapelle entrance, but we own the building. Used to be part of our intelligence network. But the place has fallen on hard times.
How can I help?
I'll keep an ear out for any opportunities that come up. You might also speak to the intendant about renovating the building itself.
I'm not exactly flush with coin just now.
Any revenues the cafe generates are yours to do with as you see fit. The money is deposited in the chest in the study, and the more improvements you make...
The more revenue.
Quite. You might also find that expanding our reach into other districts will pay dividends.
Merci. Full purse again.
It seems that workmen renovating the main wing found a small room hidden behind the kitchen. Its contents may be of interest to you. The previous owners must have walled off a room in the main hall. Perhaps you'd be interested in what they found.
Here for a fight, monsieur.
Come again.
A training match, that is. An assassin can never be too well prepared.
Isn't our mandate to work in the shadows? Stay undetected and all that?
Call this the fallback option. Better to practice here in safety than pick a fight with ruffians in the streets. No?
Touché.
Paris, September 23rd, 1788. Dear Arno, I never thought I could be so bored in Paris. Can you imagine it? The greatest city in the world. Oh, Arno, what have you done? I know we didn't part on the best of terms, but to go running to the assassins? My father kept you away from them for a reason. Their creed is like wine. Sweet enough at first blush, and in moderation it makes life seem more bearable. But drink too deeply, and you find naught but madness and anarchy. No doubt they've already filled your mind with tales of how dreadful we Templars are, that we would make slaves of humanity and place our boots on the world's neck. You knew my father, and you know me. I can only pray that is enough to give the lie to those tales. My order has turned against me, and I am hunted by those I once called friend. I could not bear it if you turned against me also. Think of me, and be well. Paris, September 23rd, 1788. Dear Arno, I never thought I could be so bored in Paris. Can you imagine it? The greatest city in the world, and here I am, stuck in endless lectures from dawn to dusk. It's worse than that winter we spent in Strasbourg. Do you remember? When it snowed for a week straight, and we couldn't leave the house, and all the books in the library were in German. We convinced that cook the house was haunted by some young Frankish prince,
and the poor man refused to leave his kitchen without a rosary in one hand and a Bible in the other. I miss those days. The things I'm learning from Father's friends are... well, I wish I could tell you about them. Someday, perhaps. But not now. And not like this. But still, I find myself missing those days. Missing home. Missing you. Next time Father comes to Paris, you must persuade him to bring you along. I remain always your Elise.
I hope I know what I'm doing.
Tonight we are here to speak on the
warning to you. Don't touch me again, or you'll get...
Godspeed, citizen.
You look terrible.
For months, I have been wrangling the Brotherhood, the National Assembly, and the King. Taken all together, they have the political acumen of an especially stupid village council. I believe that excuses my appearance, young man.
I meant no disrespect, Mentor. I'm only concerned.
Forget me, Arno. Weep for France. But enough politics. I hope you have happier news. What of Lord de Lasserre's murderers?
The King of Beggars is dead. He was carrying this.
A posant pay. You should keep it. It'll do no one any good moldering in a forgotten crypt. Carry it with honor.
Thank you. I will.
The mission.
The King of Beggars and Sivert were only pawns in a larger game. Someone sent them after Monsieur de LaSerre.
Templars do nothing simply, do they? Do you have anything solid on this mysterious chess player?
The only lead I have is the instrument that killed de LaSerre, a pin fashioned by a silversmith named Germain. But how he's involved, I can't yet say.
It seems your course is clear. Find the silversmith, learn what part he plays.
You are well, citizen?
Well, that's not suspicious, is it?
Mister yet. Could have sworn I was just behind it.
Bloody! Where'd that come from?
Well, the Pope's condemned us.
How's that?
It's all over the coffee houses. The Pope's condemned the civil...
Murderous scum!
Shit. been here 3 weeks. And I've never even seen him leave that room.
Dedicated to his work, is he?
Obsessed with his work. I don't think he really even knows we're here.
Monsieur Germain, the silversmith.
Thank God. They've been holding me for months. Please, get me out of here.
First, I need to know about this.
No time. I'll tell you all I know once we're away. But we must leave before the guards return.
Fine, let's go.
No! They'll be watching the front entrance. We'll have to go downstairs and across.
Follow me, then, and stay quiet.
Follow me.
As you say.
Wait. Thank you.
wandering? Hey, come back here! Right!
Keep moving.
Of course.
Wait here. Moving.
We. Keep one eye.
Hold a moment.
Got the most sentries there as well.
Just how important are you as a prisoner?